Hi guys, today I'm going to show you how to do kind of something cool that goes with what I've been doing with bubbles lately, but you add the fish aspect to it. So we're going to do a fish with bubbles. Now, we did some pretty neat bubbles. We did some watercolor bubbles on white paper, and we did some bubbles on acrylic, and they both turned out pretty cool, I think, from what I've seen. But for this one, what I'm going to do is I'm going to get some blue and turquoise paint, if you've got some left. If not, you can use watercolor probably for this. I'm just going to put a little bit. Ooh, I barely have any turquoise left as it is. Any, like, blue, green, something like that. And then what I'm going to do is take like a 1-inch wide brush, and I'm just going to kind of do this, going up and down. I think I'm going to make it a little bit thinner, something like this, and then go back and fill it in. Put some blue down here. I'm just making it kind of look like water, waves, something like that. But I'm just doing the middle of the page here. I don't want to do the whole thing. And there's a reason for it. Let's see how that's looking. Let me turn this off. Sometimes you can see the colors better when I do it that way. So I'm not filling the whole page. I'm sticking within, you know, a certain area here. And I'm probably going to try and make the bottom pretty flat. You can't see that. And then I'm kind of just going up. I want the sides to just be kind of like ragged. Yeah, that's looking much better. I need better lighting. Hopefully next videos that I make next week, much better lighting. Because I have it, I just keep forgetting to get it out. Because when I'm doing videos during the day, I don't need it. I've got great lighting. Okay. So. We may actually, if I were you, you might want to just leave this to dry. For a while. But I'm going to show you what to do next anyway. And you can decide. But I think I would maybe let this dry if it were me. So I'm going to go ahead and clean my brush. And the next thing I'm going to do is get a much smaller brush and some white acrylic paint. Actually, I might use this brush just because I think it'll work. So I'm going to get some white acrylic paint. If you don't have white acrylic, honestly, if you let this dry, you might even be able to do it with like chalk or a pastel or whatever you have that's white that will go over this. Later on, okay? So now we're gonna draw a fish bowl with the paint. White paint, okay? So I'm taking some white paint, and the bottom of my bowl is obviously gonna be right here, where the bottom of this is. I will have to say, where I've seen this done, it's been on the black background, like the bubbles that we did. But a lot of you don't have black or have used it up, so we're just gonna kind of go with it and do it on the white background. If you wanted to, you could go in and do this. Paint the background black first and then do this on top. Oh, look at that. It's grabbing the colors of the blue and it's working for us, I think. Because now we can do like reflections and shadows in the fishbowl. I like it. Clean the brush. Because I'm not waiting for it to dry. So now I'm going to go in and do the top. Which I might have to go back and redo the top later because it's just mixing too much. You know how fish bowls, if you've ever seen one, they've got kind of like a lip around the edge? That's what I'm doing right now. Kind of like gonna be sort of a fantasy picture because it's like the fish are gonna come out of the fish bowl and go further away in the picture somewhere else that we don't know. It's gonna swim away. That reminds me of Dory. Creole, swim away! Okay, now I'm gonna add some highlights. Like reflections. And it's okay if we need to go back and add more white. At least I'm kind of figuring out where I wanna put stuff, you know? Okay, I'm almost thinking I did the blue a little bit too wide now, but it still looks good, so. So I'm going back in with my white. I'm going to go on top of these areas that are too mixed. Add some more white. Might have to wait till they dry. Mixing too bad. Pulling right there. Oh, yeah. Yep, gonna have to go back in a little bit, I think. So I'm gonna leave that to dry for a little bit. I'm gonna turn that light back on. So I'm gonna see a little bit what it looks like, but we're gonna have to go back later and add more white on the top. Alright, so I'm gonna do some bubbles. I should have kind of sketched those out earlier, but I didn't. So, for the bubbles, I'm gonna start with white. And then we're going to pick up some blue and see if we can kind of make them look like those watercolor bubbles I was showing you earlier. So I'm actually going to add water. Pretending it's like watercolor. Yeah, something like that for our bubble. I'm gonna probably put some white bubbles on here, but for right now, it's too wet. I'll probably put like three. Thanks to the rule of thirds. back with some white and make this more white later. And I need like one more bubble. And turn my light off again so you can kind of see what I'm doing. There you go. You can see it a little bit better. Put one more like right here. It's a good spot for it. Talking much, I'm really concentrating on these bubbles. That one's too white, so I'm trying to fix it. Oopsie. Again. There we go. It's starting to get dry enough that I can add white without it smearing. A little bit, anyway. So I have kind of a fishbowl here and kind of some bubbles that we can add more white to later once they dry. I'm make sure I have a definite top to this fishbowl though. Alright, so why do we have a fish bowl that has bubbles on the outside of it? Well, the next thing we're going to do is we're going to draw a fish. So get kind of a smaller paintbrush, and you can draw whatever kind of fish you want, like the type that you would see in a bowl, like maybe a betta fish or a goldfish. I'm going to draw a goldfish for now, and so I'm going to get out my orange and some yellow. And, ooh, that's way too much orange for my fish. Might need some extra layers later, I guess. I don't know. Can't get this to snap, and I'm afraid it's going to go everywhere. Because that's what my kids would do. Not good. Okay. Usually, in the art world, orange and white are typically kind of see-through. So you might have to add a little bit of white to your orange and yellow just to make it not so see-through. But I'm going to start with some orange. I'm going to draw myself like a little fish. Like, I'm looking at the top side, the dorsal side of this fish. Just, and it's okay if it doesn't show up to start. I'm just kind of mapping out where I'm going to put it. I want it like about this big. See how see-through that orange is? It just, like, you can see the water right behind it. It's not gonna really change the color too much unless I add some white, which I will in a little bit. Make it a little bit longer. Okay. I'm going to add a smidge of white to it. I don't know that I want it to be super solid colored, but I'm just adding a little tiny bit of white to it. Then I'm going to go back and add yellow and white when it's dry. Next thing I'm going to work on is the fins, which are going to be yellow, and they're going to kind of come out and down. It's almost like I need an even smaller brush. Then we're going to do three tail thingies coming off the end. So one, I'm going to add some white. Have you ever seen Fantasia? This kind of reminds me of that a little bit. The fish in Fantasia during the Arabian dance from the Nutcracker. Tchaikovsky's. Those fish in that part. Something like that. So we have the start of a fish here. And we gotta kinda add the details of this fish. So I think I'm gonna add some yellow to the sides. Show that it goes together. So now I'm going to mix a smidge of white and yellow, like, off of the paper. Mostly I've been just mixing them, dabbing both on my brush at the same time. But what I want to do now is kind of almost show, like, where there would be scales. We'll see if it's too white. So that could work. So I'm going to do, like, scales with just the tip of my brush, just dabbing it. I dipped it in the white and the yellow. And so this is kind of what it's... Oop, starting to smear with the blue. Anyway, it's not perfect, but it kind of looks like scales, right? This is a fat goldfish, let's be honest. Not fat. It's a well-fed koi fish. Oops, I lost my white and yellow. Where did I put it? There it is. you do yours, try to not make it as fat as mine is on the bottom. It's almost like it's not the right proportion now, and I feel like it's my fault. Keep getting blue in there. Clean your brushes, folks. I'm not meaning to get blue in there. Get rid of that blue. No, no, it's too wet. What am I doing? Oh. Oh, man. Now my tissue's stuck. Fail. Epic fail. Okay, now I'm gonna go black, try the white, yellow thing, scale thing again. Oh my word. Okay, so we're about here. I think I forgot the dorsal fin. So, we're gonna go get some white and yellow on our brush, go to the middle, and kinda go this way, just a smidge, give it a little ponytail that is the dorsal fin. And go back with some more white and yellow, and just add that to it. Oh, my paintbrush has a hair on it. Not good. I think I got it. Okay, so now I think I'm gonna add, you know how koi fish kinda have some white on them? If you've ever seen those big fish in the ponds, the big goldfish, and they've got kinda some spots sometimes. So I added some of those. And some black. For the eyeball. Alright, and I'm gonna give it some eyeballs on the side of its head, like one right here, boop, and one right here, boop. Don't know why I have to say boop when I do that, but there it is, boop. Okay. My little fat orange fish that I'm going to add to as it dries. Some more color, make it more orange. Alright, I'm gonna go back and add those little details back. I just want it to be more orange. Ooh. Yeah. Looking good. As far as the scales. Okay. I'm guessing that you guys' fish are gonna look much better than mine. But here's the best part. that we're gonna go back and do right now. We're gonna add bubbles coming from the fish and going outside of the realm of the fish. So what I want you to do is just take some white and go back and just almost like the fish is blowing bubbles, and those bubbles are turning into giant bubbles outside of the fishbowl. I'm still not real happy with my fish. I hope your fishes look better than mine. But it's okay if they don't. This is a big complicated project, it looks like. Make sure you get those bubbles out there and then just sprinkle them around almost like stars and confetti and glitter. Everything should be kind of dry now, except what you just painted, so you can go back probably and add those highlights. I didn't clean my brush very good, so now all my highlights have a yellow tint to them. It's fine, right? Well, I got so much acrylic piled up right here that it's starting to peel. Whoa, it almost looks like palette knife with oil paint. That's interesting. Alright. Well, there you have the basic fish in the water, going to be out of the water, looks like. Kind of cool. I don't know how I feel about this spiky stuff going into this bubble, like if I would rather mix that together. I kind of want to. So I think I'm going to try and do that. To conceal the spikes a little bit. There we go. I think that looks a little bit better. A little less spiky. You're kind of like the opposite of what you want going on with bubbles. There we go. Cool. Well, other than my chubby fish, I think that's about it. You might, underneath the bowl, just so it doesn't look like it's floating in midair, you might want to take a little bit of blue or something and put it underneath the white to show that the bowl is sitting on a table or something, so it's not floating away like the bubbles are. Something like that. Watercolor it. It's pretty neat. Alright, and there we go. I'll show you the finished product after it dries as a thumbnail, so you can see what the dry product looks like. Anyway, upload to ArtsFunny when you're done. I can't wait to see yours. I hope your fish look better than mine. Thanks. Bye.